A colorful good morning to everyone. This is Nikita from 2nd MBZC from TTWRDC, Devarakonda. I have chosen the topic is foodborne diseases. Okay, let's see the introduction of the foodborne diseases. The first known foodborne illness was proposed by the doctors from the University of the Maryland. Foodborne illness is nothing but contaminated of the foods or beverages. Many different diseases causing microbes or pathogens can contaminate the foods. Okay, and next one is the definition of the foodborne diseases. And foodborne diseases are result as infected and injected with microorganisms or chemicals. The contaminated food may occur at any stage in the process from production to consumption. Foodborne diseases are also acute illness associated with the recent consumption of the foods. If a food is contaminated with a disease pathogenic and toxicant, such food involved may have disease pathogenic and toxicant is necessary to make a person is sick. Okay, let's see. And the next one is foodborne diseases is classified into two types, foodborne infection and foodborne intoxication. And let's see the foodborne infection. Foodborne infection is also referred as foodborne diseases, and it caused by the entrance of the microorganisms into the body in the presence of the contaminated food and the reaction of the body in the presence of the metabolites. And here the foodborne infection is again classified into two types. And the first one is the food is contaminated, and if the food is presences with the microorganisms, it does not ordinarily support the growth of the pathogens, but here it acts as a carrier for the microorganisms. And examples of these type are tuberculosis, diphtheria, cholera, typhoid fever, and etc. And second one is, if the food is contaminated with the microorganisms, it can serve as a culture medium for the growth of the pathogens. And here the examples of these type are enteropathogenic E. coli. Okay, and the next one is foodborne intoxication. Okay, let's see the foodborne intoxication. Foodborne intoxication is also referred as foodborne diseases. It is caused by the entrance of the microorganisms or ingestion of the microorganisms along with the enterotoxins, or by consuming or by the organisms by bacteria or fungi and etc., or by consuming the naturally foods that are very toxic to human and animals. And this is the brief explanation of the foodborne diseases. Foodborne intoxication and foodborne infection are the two types of foodborne diseases. If we are eaten by any contaminated food, we are affected by the diseases. What are the diseases means? The diseases are parasites, bacteria, and viruses. Examples of the bacteria are Salmonella, E. coli, gastroenteritis. And examples of the viruses are amoebiasis, infectious hepatitis. And the examples of the parasites are tapeworm infection. Okay, let's see what is bacterial food infection. The best example of the bacterial food infection is salmonellosis. So the best example of this bacterial food infection is salmonellosis. Salmonellosis is the member of the Salmonella. It is the most frequently occurring in foodborne infections, and in some yeast it is most frequently occurring in foodborne illnesses. Okay, let's see the Salmonella about the let's see the organism of the Salmonella. Salmonella organism is a gram-negative organism. It is a non-sporing forming that forms rods and that ferment the glucose with the gas production. And here Salmonella do not produce any lactose or sugar. And Salmonella is a motile, and it shows a pericritous flagella. And Salmonella has a wide range of at high temperature it grows. And the source of the Salmonella disease is unrefrigerated meat and beef. Okay, if a person is affected with the Salmonella disease, how we can detect? Okay, let's see the detection of the Salmonella disease, or by the serological test, or by the biochemical test, or by the DNA hybridization test are applied to detection of the Salmonella disease. And next, how we can prevent the Salmonella disease means C. Yeah. The prevention of the Salmonella disease is by cooking the food at a high temperature, destruction of the food with the high temperature, or by cooking or by pasteurization. Prevent the growth of the Salmonella in food or by keeping the food in refrigerators, or maintaining personal hygienic, reheating of the food, avoid contaminated foods and water. This is the explanation of the Salmonella disease. And next one is, in Salmonella, E. coli, gastroenteritis and Bacillus cereus are also included in the Salmonella disease. These are also causing many diseases. Do you know E. coli is mostly harmless, but in case enteropathogenic E. coli is very, very harmful to us. And gastroenteritis. Gastroenteritis is a disease caused in the gut of the human body or by the Clostridium perfringens. And Bacillus cereus is also causes the disease in human. And next one, Shigellosis is also one of the best example of the bacterial food infection. Okay, let's see about the Shigellosis. Shigellosis is a bacterial food infection of the bacterial food infection in foodborne diseases. Shigellosis is the member of the genus of the Shigella. Was caused by the Bacilli dysentery. Was proposed by the Japanese microbiologist by Kiyoshi Shiga, a scientist microbiologist from the Japan, has proposed the Shigellosis disease in 1898. The Shigellosis is prominent in where there are large group of people. It means it is very illness that where it is very prominent in large group of people. And next one is, the Shigellosis disease could be acquired where people can travel through the large areas. And mortality rate of this Shigellosis disease is greatest appear in infants and old people. Okay, and I want to share you one thing, that is, these foodborne diseases are mainly occurring in these persons like old people, children and immunocompromised individuals are has the greatest risk of these illnesses. Okay, and we finished the bacterial food infection. And next one is parasitic food infection. Okay, let's see the parasitic food infections. In parasitic food infections, it includes amoebiasis and tapeworm infection. If we prevent this amoebiasis and tapeworm infection, we should take some measures. What are that measures meant? We should maintain personal hygienic, reheating of the food should be very important, and if we cook the food, and it should be keeping up with the refrigerators, and high temperature of the cooked food should be taken by us. This is the prevention of this parasitic food infection. And next, causes. What are the causes of this foodborne diseases means contaminated food and contaminated water. Contaminated water contains many organisms like E. coli, Hepatitis A, cholera and Salmonella. If we drink this contaminated water, all these microorganisms get into our body, and this all microorganisms can destroy our body. So please don't avoid this contaminated food and water. So please make sure your drinking water is not contaminated. Okay, and symptoms of this foodborne diseases. And what are the symptoms of this foodborne diseases means, if a person is affected with foodborne diseases, he has to face headache, fever, diarrhea, dehydration and abdominal pain and etc. And next one, diagnosis of this foodborne diseases is, if the infected disease, diagnosis of this foodborne diseases are, the infected disease can be appeared in the laboratory test, that is, a causative organism should be diagnosed. And next, if bacteria such as Salmonella, E. coli are found in culturing bacteria, and that is sent to stool samples for the laboratory test and to identify that there was a bacteria was grown in the agar or other culture medium. And next one, parasite. Parasites can also be identified and examined under the stool samples for the microscope. And next, viruses. Viruses can also be identified and examined the stool samples for DNA makers that indicate a specific virus is present. So the in diagnosis, bacteria such as Salmonella and E. coli are also found in the culturing bacteria into the laboratory test that indicates a bacteria was grown in culture mediums. So this is the process of diagnosing the foodborne diseases. And next one, prevention. How we prevent these foodborne diseases means washing properly our hands and before washing properly our hands before and after consuming the hands. Do you know thing? Our hands contain millions of microorganisms which we cannot see with our naked eye. So please wash our hands before and after consuming the food. Intake of the food should be nutritious and healthy. Reheating of the food should be at a high temperature. And if we cook the food at a high temperature, it is not harmful to us. So this is the prevention of these foodborne diseases. And next, treatment. If a person is affected with the foodborne diseases, and the treatment as follows. Illnesses that are diarrhea, vomiting are can lead to dehydration. So as according to dehydration, and the replacing of the loss of electrolytes and loss of fluids should be keeping up with the intake of the person should be very important. If a person is suffering with severe diarrhea, he should give an oral rehydration solution to regain all his fluids, all his electrolytes to prevent the dehydration. So this is the best treatment for the foodborne diseases. And the symptoms of these foodborne diseases are the person is suffering with a headache and abdominal pain and etc. And next, lastly, I want to share one thing about eating healthy food fills your body with energy and nutrition. Do you and imagine yourself, your body cells is smiling back at you and say thank you because you eat a healthy food, right? And next one. And lastly, my conclusion to the viewers is, so please wash your hands properly before and after consuming the food. And next one is, maintain personal hygiene and maintain proper sanitization at anywhere, and cooked food should be eaten by us. Avoid contaminated food and water. A very special thank you to all for giving this wonderful opportunity. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.